You buy all the products, you put them on your face, and then your skin gets worse? Rude. Today we're busting 5 skincare myths that are ruining your skin. And I swear we are not just going to talk about wearing sunscreen every day. Myth number 1, high concentrations are better. It makes sense that we feel this way. If 5% of something is good, then 10% must be twice as good. But there's diminishing returns when it comes to skincare. It's like eating burgers. One burger is good, 2 burgers is maybe better, but then 10 burgers, you start to feel like trash. Or cake ingredients. 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract is nice, 2 is better, the whole bottle, maybe a bit much, and if the whole cake is made of vanilla extract, it's trash. Same with actives. It's about hitting that sweet spot. If you don't have enough of something, it has no effect. If you have too much of something, then it's too much. You're in side effect territory. For skincare, this is usually irritation or stripping your skin barrier. You know you've done this if your normal products or maybe even water start to sting when they get on your face. Your skin might go red and feel tight. It might be weirdly shiny. You might also get bumpy, which is sort of the opposite of what you were going for. Irritating your skin also leads to inflammation, and inflammation is also not good. There's this term inflammaging that some brands have been trying to make catch on for a while now. It hasn't really, but the gist is inflammation can speed up some of those changes that happen in your skin over time. Not good. Inflammation is also one of the 4 factors that contributes to acne. So stick with a concentration that makes your skin happy. Don't try to go higher just for the sake of going higher. And if it says to start on a low percentage, start at a low percentage. Don't try to cut corners. Myth number 2, you should exfoliate flaky skin. This also seems like it should make sense. Your skin wants to come off, so you help it off with exfoliants. But sometimes the reason skin is flaking off is because your skin's natural shedding processes are messed up, and adding exfoliants will probably mess it up more. If your flaky skin is red or irritated, then adding an irritating exfoliant into the mix is not going to help. So if that's your situation, leave it alone, let it chill. Maybe slather on a nice soothing cream like La Roche-Posay's Cicaplast Balm or even just Vaseline. Lack of hydration can also sometimes mess up your skin's desquamation. Desquamation is the fancy name for your skin's natural exfoliation process. Okay, sometimes you do need to get rid of dead skin flakes really quickly, like if you're about to put on foundation. In that case, you can exfoliate it off super gently with a damp towel or a gentle peeling gel, just to break off the dead skin at the surface. But apart from that, leave it alone. Myth number 3, using every active ingredient every day. This happens a lot. You have a day routine and a night routine, but you want to use 10 products, so you use 3 in the morning, 7 at night. Now, some people enjoy having a nice long routine, but you probably don't need one, and sometimes it is too much. Quite a lot of actives are fine being used less regularly than once a day. You can use them once or twice a week. For example, there are studies on tretinoin, which is a vitamin A product where they used it once every 3 days. Vitamin C is believed to have a depot effect. In other words, it stays in your skin and stays working for more than 24 hours. There's also exfoliation. It's usually recommended that you only exfoliate once, maybe twice a week. So you don't need to use every product every day. The best approach is to learn to listen to your skin and give it the products it needs and not mess it up more when it's already a bit messed up. I talk more about getting to know your skin in my ebook, The Lab Muffin Guide to Basic Skincare, but basically you want to keep track of what you're putting on your skin and how your skin responds. Keeping a skincare diary is a good way. Taking photos is also good. You should also change one thing at a time so you can see how your skin actually responds. And remember, if you use too much, you can get irritation. You can mess up your skin barrier and get that textured, uncomfortable, tight feeling and that stinging. That inflammation can also lead to accelerated aging and acne. I personally use a 3-night cycle. On night 1, I'll use a retinoid. On night 2, I'll use a chemical exfoliant. And then on night 3, it's the rest night where I use gentler things like niacinamide and vitamin C. For me, vitamin C is quite gentle, but for some people, it's not. So again, listening to your skin is super important. Myth number 4, cleanser doesn't matter because you're washing it off your skin. Sorting out my cleanser and my cleansing routine was one of the things that made the biggest changes to my skin. There's actually quite a lot of scientific research on cleansers, like how to make them more gentle, how to make sure they're not contributing to acne. But there's still a lot of cleansers on the market that don't follow the rules. For example, cleansers should have a low pH and contain some hydrating ingredients to stop from stripping your skin. Make sure you look up reviews from people with similar skin to you before you buy a cleanser. I actually did a couple of videos on cleansing myths a while ago, and I think I forgot this myth. I have oily skin, so when I was younger, I used a pretty harsh cleanser. I used it twice a day and it dried out my skin, but then what happened was it felt like my skin was really tight and hard and the oil just sat on top. And after I cleansed in the morning and then put on makeup, the oil came back really fast and messed up my makeup. Once I got better at skincare, I switched to a gentle cleanser once a day and my skin has been so much happier. Makeup lasts for much longer. It doesn't sort of flood back with oil as quickly. Also, if you're wearing a mask a lot, you might end up with skin issues from that. Wearing a mask means you're trapping moisture against your skin, and that extra moisture changes the microbes on your skin and also makes your barrier a bit more permeable. There's also that extra friction, and there's just a lot of irritation and inflammation going on there. Taking off your mask when it's safe and cleansing underneath is a really good idea. If you're out, you can use wipes or micellar water. Also check for how you're cleansing as well, so check your water temperature and also what cleansing tools you're using. Myth 5, sunscreens are all awful. I kinda lied, but I see a lot of people trying to make the wrong sunscreen work. I don't mean in terms of chemical sunscreen or physical sunscreen or what SPF, but just what works for you. And so many sunscreens are just annoying, they might roll off your skin, they might break you out, they might just feel really terrible. I blame men. There are a lot of white dudes in the skincare industry who don't use skincare, they use shampoo on their face, and they're making decisions about what products we get. And so this crappy sunscreen situation means a lot of us aren't using enough sunscreen, or we might just skip sunscreen altogether. But there are more women and men who use skincare, or they're just good at listening to what their customers actually want, they're more considerate, are getting into decision-making roles, and so there are a lot of better sunscreens hitting the market. So don't feel like you just have to put up with bad sunscreens. Not all sunscreens are awful. A lot of them feel really nice on your skin. And a lot of fear-mongering about sunscreen ingredients and rules for what sunscreen you're meant to use aren't really legitimate anyway. It's more about finding a sunscreen that you enjoy, so you're happy to wear it every day and you can apply a decent amount, so about a quarter teaspoon for your face. Like and subscribe to promise to yourself that you'll do better, and let me know the worst myth you believed in the comments.